Well, you guys took your sweet time. Hey guys, this is Gary the Green Mage, and welcome back to my Monster Hunter 3 videos, at least for the demo. And in this video, if I can talk, I'm going to be showing you guys all the different weapon sets slash characters that you can choose from in the demo, besides the longsword, since I've pretty much already shown that off. So, let's get started. So, this here is the medium bow gunner, and this is Jezebel. No, just kidding. This is the medium bow gun. Looks pretty cool. And what's interesting to note about the bow gun is it has different ammo types you can choose from, which you can access by opening up your item pouch in the bottom right hand corner and pressing up and down on the D-pad to choose from different ammo. So I'm not going to go through all of the ammo, but some have different effects, such as putting your opponent to sleep, cutting through armor, or piercing armor. Some of them have wide range attacks, and some of them are more focused and accurate. So I'm going to stick with the normal ammo, so I don't have to keep on reloading the gun, which you obviously have to do with any gun, is reload it before you can fire it. And to fire, you just hit the A button. Just like that, but of course that's not very accurate. So if you want to go in a first person view, you just have to tap the Z button once and puts you into a reticule first person aiming mode. You can't move around, you can't walk around while in this mode, but to look around, you just hit the move the analog stick left, right, up, down. If you want, zoom in and out, use the D-pad on the Wiimote. And again, you can fire by hitting the A button. As you can see, it's not exactly 100% accurate, but shoots off in the direction you're facing. So is there anything I can shoot around here? What the heck are those sea monsters? What? Of course, as soon as I pull out the gun, they go diving underwater for cover, so make me look like an idiot on YouTube, so I guess I just gonna shoot at a rock. Anyway, whoops, didn't mean to do that. So that's one way of aiming and looking around to fire. Another way is if you hold down the Z button, a little aiming reticule pops up and the camera goes to an over-the-shoulder view. In this one, you can actually move around, run around, walk around if you need to. Useful if you're surrounded by a lot of enemies or if you have to keep on the move and don't want to get hit. If you stop, you can actually move the reticule up, down, left, right, all over the place using the D-pad on the Wiimote. But if you move again, the reticule goes back to horizontal, the horizon, just like that. You can't aim up or down while you're on the move. Plus, you can't also move the camera while you're running like this unless you move around a bit. So, a little clunky, but I find it more useful than the first-person view in most situations. And also, last to note, with the bowgun, if you hit it, if you swipe the Wiimote up or down, can't believe it took me that long to say that, you do a little melee attack with the bowgun. So useful if an enemy gets too close to you, you can bop them on the head, then maybe run away really quick, although it's not like it's going to stun them or anything, so. I think that's pretty much it for the bowgun. Hopefully I didn't forget anything. And I'm going to see you guys on the next weapon, so see you guys in a few seconds. Hey guys, this is going to be the greatsword. So this is what the armor looks like, and this is Ursula. Yeah. Pretty big, huh? So, of course, like I said, this is the greatsword, the strongest weapon set in the demo that you can choose from, and probably in the game. Very, very slow, but it also is very, very strong. One hit from this does a lot more damage than most of the other items. Of course, you also move very slow while you have it out, but come here, come here. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. One hit, it's dead. One hit, he's dead too. And I'll leave one to tail the tail. That's right. So, very slow. You can dodge with it though, so. And the sword is so freaking big, you can also use it to block as a shield. So, it's not entirely 100% offensive. It has some defensive capability there. Defends against some attacks. Oh, look! It's the Great Jaggy! I did not plan this out ahead of time. If you use the great sword right, you can actually kill the great jaggy faster than any other weapon set. Also, if you twist the Wiimote to the left, you do a wide attack like that, which is very useful for clearing out the little jaggy. And I'm not going to show a complete battle with the great jaggy just because it still takes a few minutes. But I am going to clear out all those little jaggy first. And before I get massacred, I don't think there is much else, whoops, I can actually think of for the great sword besides those basic slow attacks, blocking. Let's see, what does this do? Oh, you can still kick with it. And this weapon set does change its attacks depending on where you twist the Wiimote, so obviously that's a little perk if you know what you're doing. So before I get eaten alive, I'm gonna see you guys at the next weapon set, so see you guys then. Hey guys, it's time to show off the good old sword and shield. And these are Chiquita and Joaquita. I thought it would be best to show off the true abilities of the sword and shield. Whoops. Bye. Where is he? Taking on the great Jaggy while he runs away from me like a ninny. Get the heck back here. And we have to chase him all the way to area number one. Sword and shield is the fastest attacking weapon set that you can choose from. See how fast I am attacking with that? But unfortunately, I do believe it is the weakest one of all the weapon sets. Which would be obvious seeing how much smaller it is than like the great sword, the long sword, the hammer, the lance. You can attack very fast with it. You can also dodge. Of course, with the shield, you can also block incoming attacks. I'm not quite sure it's as effective as most other shields. And I am going to chase him back down just because there is one more thing about the sword and shield that makes it preferable over the others. Get back here, you coward. Has a fast, unsheathing attack. But what's most useful about it over all other weapon sets is you do not have to sheath your weapon again to stop and use an item. You can still have it out. And you can continue on attacking, blocking afterwards, dodging quickly if you need to. So that saves on a lot of time and is very useful if you want to, like, throw something without having to sheath your weapon. What can I throw? Dung bomb. See? Still have my weapon out. I can block if I need to. Let's see if I can block against one of these attacks. Oh, I guess I can. So, shield is useful for blocking damage. Again, attack fast. Minus button does an around slash. So, a quick round slash in front of you. If someone's jumping around you really quick like a jaggy, this weapon is useful for taking them out. Let's see. Yeah. Not quite sure if there's anything else. I know I'm missing a few things, but that's pretty much the gist of it for the sword and shield. So, see you guys at the next weapon set.